dreams come true. Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
Because the truth of the matter is that getting what you want is actually really simple. But notice, I didn't say it was easy. And earlier I was talking about getting in shape or losing weight, and it's actually pretty simple, right? You pick a freaking program and you follow it. Any diet will work, the problem is you alter it. Any exercise program will work, the problem is you don't do it. That's what makes it hard. And that's true about everything in life. It comes down to knowing what you want and then making a plan. And then the real hard part, which is sticking to it. And I know you don't have time to do any of this stuff. And I'm going to start by explaining to you what the best practices are, and in particular, the best practices for this industry. And then I'm going to explain to you how your brain works and why the only thing that's standing between you and having whatever it is that you want and being more effective and making more money and being happier is your head. And not your head in terms of your thoughts, it's your head in terms of how it's wired and how living in modern life is screwing it up. So first of all, this is scientifically, based on all this research. So the Harvard Business School published a study where they took a look at several dozen CEOs around the planet that are billionaires and also happen to be happy. And they found something very interesting, that they all had something very interesting in common. And what they had in common was how they structured their day. And the most important thing about being effective at work and feeling in control, which are vital to you doing and achieving what you want, is how you start your day. And almost every single one of these CEOs said that they had a morning ritual where they spent 30 to 90 minutes working at home, developing a plan and setting up what they were going to do before they went to work. And the reason why is, you know exactly why. The second you walk in the door at work, your day is hijacked. You're interrupted. It's a place of distractions. In fact, it's probably the place where you get the least amount of work done. But at least that way, they found that when they got to work, they already had gotten out of the way the strategic things that they needed to think about. The other thing that's interesting is you should never have meetings in the morning, ever. You should never do people stuff in the morning. You shouldn't have phone calls in the morning. And here's why. Because in terms of how the brain works, you have about a 2.5 hour window after you wake up. So you've got about a half an hour. You wake up, then you've got a half an hour of time where you're kind of getting awake and kind of coming into the day, and your brain is almost starting to turn on. And then you've got a 2.5 hour window where you can do your best thinking and the highest level of processing. And so what you want to do is you want to reserve the mornings in terms of how you block out your time. And I realize a lot of you are sitting in front of monitors all day and checking out CNBC and looking at alerts and looking at research and everything else. But for crying out loud, the morning time, there, you should not be in meetings, ever. You need to make sure those are scheduled in the afternoon. You need to make sure people things are scheduled in the afternoon, because you will naturally dip also at 2. Instead of having a Diet Coke or a 15th cup of coffee, if you're in a meeting, the energy of the other people will actually wake you up. And then the final thing that they said that was really interesting is almost all of them try to have a relaxing evening, because you cannot power through 23 hours a day and be effective. It's impossible. In fact, if you don't get enough sleep, they've tested this out, and if you don't get the amount of sleep that you need, which is between 7 and 8 hours, let's say repeatedly in a row you get 5 hours of sleep in 3 days, just 5 hours, 3 days in a row, legally you act in terms of a cognitive fashion as if you're legally drunk. It affects your processing that much. I know you guys are like, I don't care. Okay. This is how the average person spends their day. 28% of your time reading and answering freaking email. Do you know 83% of your work years, 83 days a year at work, you know what you're doing? Email. It's unbelievable. And most of you spend too much time responding to emails. And the best philosophy for email, and almost nobody follows it, is if it requires more than 1 or 2 sentences to respond, flag it and save it for later. Save it for the afternoon where you do the people stuff, okay? So let's talk about your morning routine. What's the first thing that you did this morning? Hit the snooze. It's true. The majority of people hit the snooze alarm. Now, I don't have some big agenda for you to get up early, but I do want you to do something tomorrow. I want you to set your alarm a half an hour earlier. I know you're like, oh, they've got an open bar with free alcohol tonight. This chick is out of her mind. I'm not doing it. No, I want you to set your alarm for a half an hour earlier. And the reason why is I want you to do a little neurological test with yourself. You're going to set the alarm for a half an hour earlier. When that alarm goes off, many of you are staying in a hotel room, and so you're going to be all cozy, and there's no kids or pets or partners or anybody else in that bed, and you're going to want to sleep in. What you're going to do instead is you're going to throw the sheets off, and you're going to stand up in that cold hotel room, and you're going to walk toward the bathroom. And the whole time, you're going to be like, I hate that freaking woman that was talking yesterday, and why am I doing this? Because she's not here. And the reason why I'm asking you to do that is because I want you to understand what scientists call activation energy. Activation energy is the physical force that is required to get you to do something different than what your body's already doing. So it's the same amount of energy that it takes, for example, if you're sitting at the computer and you know you got to go to the gym, the same amount of energy that's required to force your ass out of bed 30 minutes earlier instead of hitting the snooze is the exact same amount of energy that you're going to need to force yourself to get up from the computer, to force yourself to put down the croissant if you're on a diet, to force yourself to have the tough conversation that you've been avoiding with your boss. And I want you to come and do this experiment because you're going to become face to face with what a complete stubborn jerk you are. And you resist yourself all day long. You do.